Hi guys, I'm Manish. I am currently, pursuing my passion of being a fitness trainer. I have been into fitness and I am trying to, make sure that I stay fit, especially in this, COVID situation. We are stuck at home and we are not able to find that, urge to go out, and we have been lying on our beds and becoming couch potatoes. So I actually pushed myself and, started thinking about how can we go forward and, be healthy. And that's what I'm trying to promote and trying to help people stay fit, both physically as well as mentally.
Coming to the point, what are your five tips to keep our weight in control or to lose weight?
So guys, it's as simple as so I will actually put it in a different way by saying that you should have it very clear in your minds that how to not lose weight. So people will give you certain examples that they lost weight within a day, within a week. No, there is no, fixed medicine which can make you lose weight so quickly. So make sure that anyone who says you can lose weight quickly is saying it in a wrong way. I mean, yes, there are medical ways to do it, like liposuction and all, where you are removing the fat entirely, but those are not healthy ways. Those are unnatural or artificial man-made ways to reduce weight, and that is not the way you should be going for it. It's as simple as, actually, Sai mentioned it already. It's as simple as calorie deficit, which is basically how much calorie you are consuming and how much you are working out to make sure that your calories intake versus output overall, the expenditure versus intake should be negative, which means you are expending more than what you are taking. It's as simple as that. There is no fixed medicine, there is no fixed diet as well. So different body types behave differently. I have seen so many of my friends who eat rice and they don't become fat. I have seen so many friends who eat chapatis, sweets, anything and everything, and they don't become fat. So there is no fixed way. But you have to tune your body in a way where you are actually, able to, again, more spend than what you are intaking. As simple as that.
Coming to the another point, how to remain in calorie deficit, because we are habituated to eat some amount of calories. If you ask them to eat at less calories, suddenly in the midnight they'll get hungry. How to overcome this?
So guys, our body, and obviously Sai is a doctor, so he would know it better, but from the body physiology, what happens is we have a metabolic memory. From what I've studied, actually when we eat, we get more hungry. Especially on the type of food, it depends. For example, carbohydrates actually make you a little more hungry. Based on the past behavior, what we have done is we have been able to eat a lot more. So if you have those cravings, if you have to directly answer Sai, it's actually gonna be a habit. Initially, it's gonna be difficult. So you have to, stop those cravings, have some water, or have a light snack. For example, digestive biscuits, one or two, is not a bad idea. That's perfectly fine. Having a bit of nuts just to, crave that hunger pangs per se of yours, that's a good idea. That's not a problem. But yes, going and eating a lot at that point of time is gonna cause a problem. So you have to make a mental note that no, I'm gonna eat this much and I'm not gonna eat, a lot more. For example, if I have a crazy sweet tooth, I love eating desserts. That's perfectly fine. If you are eating a little more, work out the next day a little more as well. As simple as that. Again, managing, you're spending a lot more. By the way, a lot of people don't think this, but while sleeping, you lose a lot of calories as well. So make sure you have a healthy diet as well as a healthy sleep. Don't skip on your sleep, or don't think that, more working out, rigorous working out is gonna give you that weight loss. Yes, it will, but again, make sure that you are not hurting your body in a way where it is impacting your health adversely. So as simple as that, if you're eating a lot more, exercise a lot more, or make it a mental habit that you don't have to eat a lot. Control your portion sizes. Slowly and steadily. Nowadays, I don't feel like eating because I know I have to do this. And now my body has developed that mechanism within, let's say, 2, 3 weeks itself, that I don't feel hungry itself because I know what is going to happen.
Coming to another point regarding rice versus wheat, what do you prefer, roti or
That's a good question, Sai. So I'm a North Indian. I love chapatis. Having said that, it's not actually about chapati or rice. Chapati and rice both actually have carbohydrates. So you have to manage your diet in a way that you are actually limiting your carbohydrates. So when we are fat, when we want to lose weight, the first thing which we want to burn is the fat which is accumulated on the body. What happens is when you're working out, the carbohydrates get burned quicker. The first thing which is utilized is the carbohydrates, and then your fats actually get to the level of burning. So be it rice, be it wheat, both of them are carbohydrates. If you are eating them in more quantity, what will happen is you're going to consume them whenever you're going to work out. You're going to use them, but not actually cut your fat. So slowly and steadily, it's a mix of both. It's carbohydrates plus exercise. So limiting your carbohydrate intake and then exercising at the same time is going to give you that impact of actually reducing weight in the longer period. I'm talking about the healthy way. It may take 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks. There are people who would want to, you know, go on a keto diet or a, you know, starving kind of a situation. I would say don't do that, because that's not sustainable. If you do a dieting, let's say from tomorrow onwards, you skip on one meal, you're going to feel more hungry. You will feel restless. Your body will not be able to accommodate it. So you have to slowly taper it down. Start eating, start reducing slowly and steadily. And then your body will become habitual to burn that fat which is accumulated rather than the carbohydrate you are taking in. You would have heard of keto. Keto is again an extreme way of doing it. Many people are able to do it, but it's actually mentally very tiring. You're not able to eat a lot of things. It's mentally cumbersome. And that's why I feel keto is not a long-term sustainable diet per se. So you have to keep it limited and, you know, not go for a longer, you know, version of you getting that urge to eat more.
Coming to another important thing, staying away from cravings. How do you do that?
Sorry, Sai, I didn't get your question.
Staying away from junk food, how do you do that?
So guys, I mean, I am not the right person to say this, but there are so many, you know, brilliant, I would say chefs, home chefs, professional chefs, health, fitness, nutritionists who are actually able to, you know, make delicious food. So when you think about a snack, it's not junk. Why do you eat junk? You eat junk because you want to, you know, satisfy those different taste buds of yours, which is saying, okay, I want to have tangy. I want to have sweet. I want to have spicy. That's perfectly fine. You are human. You have to do that. But the point is, eat at home or make stuff which is available at home. You can always make it spicy. That's not a problem. Obviously, you know, excess of anything is wrong and you should not be doing it. But having said that, you want to make, let me say, spicy. So, you know, chana, simple chana, kala chana, add tomato, pyaz. So tomato, onion with kala chana. And put some chaat masala, namak, kali mirch, salt, pepper. However you want to make it spicy, it feels refreshing. It feels yum. I have everyday sprouts. And I love sprouts. I love the crunch of it. Sometimes I have raisins and almonds. Sometimes I have tomato and onion into it. So make it, you know, how you would want to. And to be very honest, and Sai, I mean, this might go against a lot of nutritionists. It's perfectly fine to eat junk. Guys, it's okay. The only thing is, don't do it every day. Do it, let's say, once a week, once in 2 weeks, or when if you are habitual or if you have started learning how to make the taste healthy food tasty as well. And there are so many options of tasty food and healthy food as well. So it's just how you are making it. For example, my mom doesn't like, you know, egg whites without egg yolk. But if I add one egg yolk and two egg whites, she doesn't mind it. So I'm limiting the quantity of egg yolk with the more egg whites. So you have to, you know, make it in a way that it still seems interesting. You don't really crave for it. And yes, whenever you have a craving, it's okay to eat it. Go eat out, you know, limit your portions, try to control a bit. And the next day or the next week, I would say, depending on how much you have eaten, make sure you are working out that little 5 minute extra, that little 10 minute extra. So that's perfectly fine. We are humans at the end of the day, and it's sustainable. It's long term. If you are eating your favorite foods, but limiting them, you will still, you know, create that value of it, and you will not go, you know, लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल वो बोलते हैं ना घर की दाल, इट्स एज सिंपल एज दैट, इट बिकम्स सिंपल. माई मॉम डज इट इन यू नो माई मॉम डज इट इन सो मेनी वेज. Sometimes she does jeere ka tadka, sometimes she does some other thing, sometimes, I mean, I don't even know half of the times, but you can keep it spicy, you can keep it only tomato tadka, only onion tadka, tomato plus onion tadka, with garlic, with pepper, without pepper. There are so many ways to make your food interesting and your taste buds satisfy. To be honest, we don't really know what those, you know, ingredients are, but when you limit, actually start feeling them. Oh, this is pepper. Oh, this is salt. Oh, this is cinnamon. So to actually enjoy and cherish that, I think it's a very good idea to actually limit your food and start taking an interest, or even if your parents are making or if you are cooking, start taking an interest, start understanding how spices are. So that tang which you're looking for in the junk, which you are calling junk, in the outside restaurant food, you can actually create that at home. And there are multiple ways of doing that.
Thank you so much, Manish, for joining us. I'm so glad to have you.
Absolutely, Sai. Pleasure talking to you. Guys, you know, I would say I have also created some fun workouts. Go check out my profile. Get inspired with Manish. I think Sai is doing a fabulous job at inspiring you guys, connecting with different people who are in this industry and actually making sure that, you know, how you can get... Okay, someone is commenting. Sorry, Sai, I'm taking that. Bahut badhiya English, Oxford University. Yes, Prateek, thank you so much. Make sure you are following my page on Get Inspired with Manish. I've created some fun workouts. IPL is in the air. I am a Chennai supporter, though I am a North Indian, but I am a Chennai supporter. Dhoni by heart, yellow is still wearing. But yes, guys, do make sure you are eating healthy and working out so that you are maintaining a calorie deficit. But at the same time, satisfy those hunger pangs now and then and make sure you are also cherishing the food which you like. Pleasure talking to you guys.
Thank you. Bye.